Only on 7, a Nob Hill home saturated in cat feces and infested with spiders becomes the fourth case of extreme cat hoarding in the city in just over a week.
Action 7 News reporter Lauren Zakalik is live outside the eyesore on the corner of Gold and Pine. Lauren, what can you tell us?
You guys, dozens and dozens of cats have been taken from this home, 60 cats in total. This is the fourth case of cat hoarding in the city in the past few days. And by the looks and smell of things here, it's potentially the worst. An empty can of cat food tossed in the front yard of this home on Gold Avenue Southeast doesn't even start to tell the story.
It's like smelling the largest litter box you could ever imagine, coupled with a bathroom that hasn't been flushed or cleaned in a couple of weeks.
We broke the news to Bill Cobb that his neighbor had been hoarding 60 cats inside this home. He was disgusted, but after dealing with this mess for years, he says it's entirely plausible.
There's nothing gross that you could tell me that's going on in that house. It'd be a surprise to any of us that live here.
According to the Safe City Strike Force, the house is covered in cat feces, urine, and trash, infested too with spiders and flies. The red sign on the door says the home is now unlivable.
The animal lover in me is like, I'm like, 60 cats? Like, how could you let something, anything live in that kind of environment?
With 60 cats living in this home, it's no surprise that the stench of cat urine can be smelled from yards away. One neighbor says the smell has really been unbearable, but the man who has all these cats was simply trying to do, she says, a good thing.
Can we talk to you?
He tried to get his side of the story.
Sir, do you live here?
But the man here clearly did not want to talk. This is the fourth and largest cat hoarding case in the city this month alone. A problem not just for the hoarders, but for their neighbors and the city as well. Now, we are told that this man is being cooperative with the city, is working with them to get rid of the cats. We're told he was able to keep one of those cats tonight, as you just saw in the story. He was at the home earlier today, but it's unclear right now if he has left. According to the city, he had to have left by tonight. Reporting live in Southeast Albuquerque, Lauren Zakalik, KOAT Action 7 News.
Well, last week, Animal Control removed 53 cats from a Northwest Albuquerque home, where they also found dead cats as well. The two other cases had fewer cats, but enough, obviously, to pose a problem and a health risk.